reason I'm writing this like printing paper, because we are using water-based ink. If we have dry paper to print, when paper gets wet, it starts to expand. So if you want to print a second layer or print again, paper is bigger than the original. So it will off the register, right? And then if paper is dry and your ink is wet, you get rejection from the dry paper. Because they are not in the same condition, they reject, repels your ink. So it won't, you cannot transfer 100%. So you get a little, like a texture on your paper. It doesn't look very uniform, it looks very sludge. And then that's the second reason. Here's three. You can't remember.
You know. Because the printing god said so?
Right, so mix it with water. Okay, and then we have these brushes, you don't have to have your own. And this is the bar end. This is the traditional bar end. It looks like. And that's the cheaper version. And sometimes you can use like a metal ball bearing. Okay, but that one costs about $1,500.
$1,500?
To buy. And it takes about 6 months to make one.
What's inside of it?
Well, what's inside is this. You know, you go to like the San Antonio Zoo, you can see the bamboo. Well, you know, bamboo grow each chamber. When the one complete the one chamber, the sheets fall down. They grow the next one. That's that.
Was that what you were saying, that you were looking for bamboo trees and things like that for people?
Is this bamboo?
Yeah,
it's not the shedding. It's the shedding of the skin of the bamboo as it grows.
You can find these. Just if you look at the big bamboo sticker one, you can see, look under the floor. I found a few.
It looks like the palm
tree
stuff at my
house. So what's the difference between those two? You said one's an expensive one.
Oh, yeah.
One's
So. The brain. So that's the disc called the body, like that. And that's a little coil, like pencil. And then it's wrapped around with the bamboo sheet.
What's the purpose of the coil?
What is the difference in this one and this one?
That one is a bamboo coil.
Uh-huh.
And that one has a synthetic.
Like that right there?
Yeah. Something like that, but it's more like you buy at the, like a hardware store, like a laundry liner, like that.
Plastic
but
one.
Yeah, plastic, but it's more stiff. Yeah.
Like a clothesline.
So they wet this and twist it up and make it into a rub or something?
That's what you're showing us on that one? That's the
thing. So depending on how many times you twist, you get finer and some of them more rough, right? To having the rough one like that, if you have a thicker paper, so you count the less teeth count, go for thicker paper. So imagine, okay, I'm trying to make a hole, right? Punching a hole into any surface. If you have one needle, I can easily go through, right? But imagine if you have many needles, try to push something, you can slip there because your pressure is distributed evenly, right? So if you have a thinner sheet, it's better to use more teeth count, because and then it spread more the pressure evenly. When you have a less teeth count, you can press, you can transfer pressure more. You can lift up all the ink. So depending on how thick is your paper, you have to choose different.
So do you prefer one over the other one of these?
It depends, really, depending on what paper and then what the surface. So if you imagine you're printing flat or printing just thin lines, completely different. So it takes about 6 months to make one like that. Mm. Just few people left in Japan.
Well, it's just amazing.
Backyard, it's supposed to dry. It'll turn yellow. Yeah.
I have plenty.
And then I shade it down like that. Just cut one, two, and then split. Mm-hmm. So this is the whole bristle. I get it from hardware store, paintbrush.
Mm. Just red old bristle.
Yeah, just natural bristle, and you just trim it off and just wrap around with a thread. And I put glue other side, and that goes inside.
What kind of glue?
Just any water proof, like a wood glue, green glue, like that.
So you bought a natural bristle paintbrush or something and cut it out?
Yeah, it goes inside. And you wrap around. Let me show you the
saffron palm trees.
Okay.
My next door neighbor at his pool's got like a half a dozen of them all over the place, and they fluff into my yard.
So even I have only big ones.
Oh my!
Yeah.
They look like makeup. And then you attach. Yeah.
You made both of those?
No, that's the one you buy in Japan, and they're coming all different size. They're like tiny as like a quarter, like half inch width, and come to that big.
And why would you use different sizes?
It's you get some are like a small, some are big, yeah. But depending what, see, I'm printing this flat, so I'm using bigger size.
Okay.
Of course.
What kind of little cord is this?
Just a linen thread.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
And what else you can tell you? I also make a carving tools. Okay. Or like that. So
carving for
it, it opens it up and you put the blade inside. Yeah. I don't really have finished in here. You have to get a one with a 45 degree angle.
Yeah.
And I immediately shave this down.
To take the point off of it?
The point off, because it will break right away. So you have to carve the back side.
With
45.
You grind it?
Yeah, just use a grinder.
Oh, okay.
Or like the sharpening stone or sandpaper. Mm-hmm. You just have to rub it.
So instead of this peak, you want it to be this?
Yes, yes.
Okay.
So I don't know if I can show you.
Are you kind of round it?
See how different?
Yes, he takes up the root too.
So I just take off the back, because that is so pointy. It will break right away. How doesn't matter how much experience you have, you will still break.
Sorry.
That's okay.
So I come up with this design. That I go to Alamo Hardwood Store, and then they sell these little scraps of
wood.
They're cheap. They are all the leftovers, and I put two nails on the bottom. Or near the edge, and what happens when you slide this in?
Okay.
Oh.
It won't move because you always pull like that, right? When you cut.
Yes.
So you get a support from the nail. Okay.
How simple.
Drill and then hammer, and then I just filed it to make it more like a square, so I can slide my.
Wow.
Blade inside.
So in essence, you make your own exacto knife almost.
Yeah.
It's
very simple,
uh-huh.
But it's perfect. I tried many different. First, I put a piece of metal to hold from moving, but it's not enough. So it's not strong enough.
Mm-hmm.
And the metal comes off because I pull and push very hard. And some of these, I don't know, I put something in the middle. That's finally, I come up with a design.
Like a simpler is stronger?
Yeah, simpler is better, but it still works. So just two pieces of nail, it goes in, and when I put the cover on, like that, it stays in tight. It won't come, because I don't have to worry about moving down, because I never
go that direction.
Pull that, yeah. I only pull that direction.
Okay.
And won't come. I have to just give you a little more guide. Yeah.
Did you make that brush over there?
That one? No, I didn't make this. But this is also not that difficult to make.
Engineers.
If you have a power drill, then you go back. You need to have really long
space.
Yeah. So you tie one end and go to the other side, go back and forth a few times. Attached to the drill, and it. That's it.
Yeah, somebody needs to follow you around with a video camera.
That's creative.
They won't scratch the paper. Sometimes people use bottles, wooden sticks and stuff. They all scratch your paper, except this guy.
The glass will scratch?
Scratch, yeah.
Wow, weird.
Doesn't matter how fine it is. And then that one is slide much better. It's very smooth and has slightly oil. Hmm. You know, even if you cooked it very long time, you know, still.
Well, you know, our bones, that's what they're meant to do. Support, but they also have to slide at the joints, so maybe that's built in.
It's perfect. And the first few are not. The impression, first couple are kind of test still, and then when everything settled, and then you can have more consistency. So I'm going to print without the paste and with the paste and see how different. Put this back in there.
You still have one out.
There's still one on the
paper. So do you make, I guess there's no way for you to make the curve tool then to use, or do you make the curve tool?
The U-shaped?
U-shaped, no, I don't make this.
Look how it, you see how it's curved? I mean, if you look at it from all sides, it's, so I don't know how they did that.
You know how you make the shape? You use a hot plate. So when you finish making brushes, they're all flat, uh-huh. Right? Straight and even. And then the tip is very thick, right? So you use a hot plate to burn it. It goes around.
And it doesn't singe it.
Well, you are singeing it.
No, but I mean, it doesn't leave us, you know, like a singe mark. Yeah.
Yeah. This how people do it. You burn it.
It's black, so.
Making the shape, right?
Yeah, but it would affect
it has to be round. You shouldn't have any sharp edges and corners. So what happens after you burn, all the tips are now thick and kind of burned like around, a little burr around
it.
So what happens, you use a shark skin.
That's great.
Yeah, this is with the grain and this is against the grain.
The grain.
Wow. So do you want the shark skins? You should have a list
that
of things you want.
So
the
weather's been so dry, when you stretch
shark
it in,
skin?
It's,
it's a black market.
Yeah.
what do you do with
it? I didn't know we had black market here.
What do you do with it?
Soak it and you stretch it. But it's been so dry here, it starts to tear, so I have to fix that. Anyway, so I soaked it for it in the cold water and then in my bathtub. This was only really
I'm sure your children enjoyed that.
My children. I had there was Matilda's one, maybe. They want to swim in the shark.
That's right. Mm-hmm. So you put that in there so they could claim they swam with the shark?
Yeah,
that's
so
right.
But I had to stay. Because
it's
sharp.
It's microdermabrasion at the same time.
You never round these tips. We have to split it into many strings.
The feather it.
Yeah. So the middle, the bottom is just one thick hair.
Right.
But the tip, you can see many.
They split ends.
Yeah.
Exactly.
So what happened, bring the shark skin.
Yeah,
it's
interesting.
So
you shape
split
your
it.
Brushes with this. After
and then all
those
the tip, they start to split into fine. Otherwise, you will make a huge rush mark. You can't really use these.
It would almost be
do
like
you have to
spread.
Do that after you buy them? Or they already come that way?
Depends.
Straight
from the
don't
tube,
kill.
They are very, very thick. So you just keep it like that, and then grab another jar. So that might be too dark. So you just simply just take some water and just
drizzle it in.
Just add it to. So water is like your transparent base. So a lot of times people don't really use white ink. They change the color. But just adding water will give you more consistency. And our printing without the, I think I put a little too much ink. But you need a little more ink at the beginning because you don't have any. So first you make a circle. Like that. that motion. And if you have any, see a big puddle, you can just clean it with a corner like that. And then with the grain direction, and then you always finish against the grain direction. But you only use the side of the brush and feel like you don't use any muscle. You have to be relaxed and you feel like you're not touching it. Like in Japan, you know, with the master, with the apprentice, and then people, printing flat is difficult. And then you always get this brush mark. Mm-hmm. You try over everything, try everything. You still get the mark. Mm-hmm. And then one time, the apprentice, he did perfect print. And then the master asked him, what did you do any different? And he said he didn't touch it. Mm-hmm. But he did it. But it's how light you have to go against the grain. So it's something you have to practice, is how you hold the paper with your index, middle finger, and your thumb, your right hand, goes to the corner to hold, mm-hmm. and then just drop it. Mm-hmm. And just a little oil to help, you know, like a Vaseline or something. Or and I have wax paper for you. Start from the middle, just spread outside. And then circle around. You can also go around zigzag like that.
It's like a substantial amount.
I try to use my upper body weight so that I don't have to use my arm muscle. So your arm is like there's a joint spring, but then my body weight actually goes to my hand. So I don't use my hand. It gets really tough. I mean, imagine you print hundreds of paper, just use your arm. You can't do that. It's too hard. So just use your upper body weight. You know, if table is lower, even better. So in Japan, this printing table is slightly angled down, so you can use your body, control your whole body.
What keeps the paper from sliding? Just because it's wet?
See the other layers of paper.
Oh, okay.
That's the magic.
It seems like
you get a lot of texture.
Mm-hmm. So your color that you got
is so clean.
It's like a very neutral. So you have blue in there. What else is in your color?
Just put some blue, tint, black.
Tiny bit of black and lots of
water. Emily, you ruined it. See, that paper slide, but not the bottom. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I guess you can use that cooking
parchment. But not ceramic.
This is just generic wet paper, or it's specific for
this? It's made for printing.
Okay.
You don't have to.
It costs it expensive.
It's got thousands of
dollars. Once again, it's costly. It's expensive.
It gets darker, but I didn't miss any water registration. Still. Simple spoon like that with a bamboo.
Oh, yeah.
Just to heat it up a little bit, the tip, and bend it up, or I guess it will work. Whatever, any hit you have.
And all that is rice paste, right?
Yes.
Just old rice and
it's
water.
It's called nori. So either you can buy.
I bought nori paste. Is it the same?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. It's like nori. Like
you just have to mix it with water, 50-50, because when you buy, it's too stiff. Mm-hmm. So add more water. So make it, you know, see the consistency of what? Like a yogurt or something?
Like kefir.
I like that one. I don't know. I like to compare with food.
It's the universal language.
But it gives you an idea.
It's way too long. You know, it doesn't matter how many workshops I did. Like if I don't practice, so the same, exactly the same way, you know, finish. I guess you don't have to finish against the grain, but to get the uniform, no brush mark, this is the best way to achieve.
Do people ever try to manipulate the brush mark? Keep it? Sure, part of it is
Just, you just have to remember how you finished the last stroke.
That's going to be the hardest part for me, because it's dropping the paper.
Just watching you do it, it looks effortless, but I know it's going to be that way for me.
Holding paper is registered. So just check the corners, make sure you didn't miss anything. And then, oh, how did I get this back in? Hey, from this one.
It's.
See, I reduce some texture quite a bit.
Oh, it's a paste.
This paper material. But, you know, in art class, I'm just going to print. I'm not really careful, just push everywhere, see what happens.
Oh, wow, it's just
okay.
Perfect.
Yeah, got these? Mark?
Yes.
Ah. It's not very good. But you have to spray it upward.
Okay.
And then everything just settles down.
What are you spraying?
Water system. Because if you put it on directly, you'll get too much water.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's just type of tool.
Yeah, and that's enough. And then you just get them off. Okay. You know, and then you start to relax. Smooth, no wrinkle, no creases. And then you can put your paper inside.